Simple rules for this matchup, and you can already feel the heat beginning to emanate from ringside as the flames have surrounded the ring. And here comes a man who's never been in this situation before, Montel Vontavious Porter. And you gotta wonder, JBL, what is going through MVP's head right now.
Who the hell has been in this situation before? Only a couple people in the world have stepped in there with Kane. This is insane. What could possibly go through your head?
From Miami, Florida, weighing in at 238 pounds, Montel Vontavious Porter, MVP.
Let me put this in perspective, Michael. Somebody is going to get burned. You have 6 foot flame, 500 degree heat. We've had to move our announce table back 3 feet. We've moved the fans back 3 to 4 feet for their safety. But who is going to worry about the safety of MVP and this monster Kane?
An absolutely look of concern on the face of MVP surveying the ring here. The flames have already begun to burn here in this fourth ever Inferno match.
And this is the lowest these flames will burn. They're burning this low, Michael, just to let the competitors get into the ring.
And John, talking to the chief pyro technician earlier on today, explaining this will be the biggest and the baddest Inferno match ever. The flames will actually creep up to an 8 foot level at times with degrees of 500 degree heat here at ringside.
And making his way to the ring, weighing in at 323 pounds, Kane!
And here is a man, JBL, and look at the look in the eyes of Kane. He is sick, he is demented, and you gotta believe that this is his backyard, that he loves this type of match. Oh my God!
And Freak is at home in this.
Did you see how high the flames?
Somebody is going to get burned alive in this match. The hell is Teddy Long thinking? And look at Kane. Look how sick that monster Kane is. A sadistic human being as I have ever seen in my life. He's actually at home right now.
We're about 6 feet from ringside, JBL, and you can feel how hot those flames are at this point in time. Imagine being inside the ring. An MVP perhaps looking for escape, but he can't do it.
Not only be inside the ring, understand also, oxygen is burned up by fire. The longer this match goes, the less oxygen these guys have to breathe in the middle of that ring.
MVP trying to beg out of the matchup. Kane wouldn't have it. Big boot to the face, and I guess, JBL, it's time to talk strategy. What is the strategy for this type of match?
Winning is a bonus. Survival. You want to not get burned. This is the craziest match I have ever heard of in my life.
And MVP whipped into the corner, big boots to the face of Kane. And look at how close those flames are to the corner, nearly lapping at the boots of MVP. Heading up to the top rope, but perhaps losing confidence a bit as he wasn't quite sure when the flames were going to come up just like that. So if MVP was on the top rope and the flames leaped up like that, perhaps he would have been burned and lost the matchup.
To be hesitant. Oh, you have some type of trepidation. I'm sitting here 6 feet from him, and I'm hesitant.
Kane working on MVP, the big red machine,
he's already trying. Look at him. He's already trying. Kane's already trying to stick his hand in the flames.
MVP whipped into the corner again by Kane. Clubbing blow to the back of the head.
You can't put this in perspective enough, Michael. Somebody is going to get burned by fire in this match.
MVP trying to crawl to the bottom rope, but as he does, he's crawling closer to the flames. Remember, there are no rules in the matchup, so there's no break here. MVP up to the top rope and slam to the mat below. And look at how close MVP is to the flames that are surrounding the ring. This is such a unique matchup. It is so rare. There have only been three other matches, Inferno matches, in the history of World Wrestling Entertainment. extremely dangerous. And Kane putting MVP in the top rope. Now, if these flames leap up to that eight foot height here, MVP could be burned. Or if he's knocked off the top rope as well, John. And MVP realizing he's in trouble and knocking the big hit.
Good Lord!
Did you see how close those flames came to MVP? Lost body, lateral press, but there are no pinfalls in this matchup. And the heat increases at least threefold whenever the flames leap into the air.
It's hard to believe what we're watching right now.
MVP, definitely the underdog in the matchup. And a boot to the jaw of Kane would be a monumental upset if MVP could pull it off here against the Big Red Machine.
Look, MVP is in Kane's house right here.
Oh,
God.
Kane sitting up, and MVP realizing he's in deep, deep trouble.
And there's no place to go. Where are you going to go? You've got to stand there and fight this big monster.
And normally when things aren't going well, you can get out of the ring and take a breather. You can't really do that in this type of situation.
And you can barely breathe in there. That is 500 degrees.
Wow! And the Big Red Machine off the big boot, measuring MVP. And Montel Vontavious Porter, who has defeated Kane in a steel cage match in a street fight.
Nobody, Michael, deserves this cop of punishment. Nobody, not MVP, not anybody.
MVP going for the wide touch slam by Kane. As the flames seem to be an exclamation point to the chokeslam. MVP in trouble as this sick, demented monster Kane releases the covering from the steel turnbuckle. Again, this is all completely legal. What the hell's Kane gonna do with this? Look at him.
Oh, come on.
Kane with that turnbuckle covering.
He starts fires, he puts got fires out. Look at the goofy powers does this maniac have. Now, come on, somebody stop him.
He's trying to burn Kane with that turnbuckle. I should say MVP with that turnbuckle cover. It's now on fire, and MVP luckily tosses out of the ring for his safety.
The ropes on this side of the ring are melting.
MVP with the knees to the skull, going for a neck breaker. Now what MVP has to do is try to drag that carcass, that 300-pound carcass, toward the flames to catch it on fire. And there's a drop kick. And, well, perhaps this is the strategy, to use drop kicks to drive Kane closer to the flames. Oh, my God, Kane is moments away.
He's going to do it.
Getting burned. Nobody hurt. MVP almost sliding into the fire. That close.
MVP had to get burned off that.
It is an awe-inspiring sight to see this ring surrounded by these flames.
No.
And one of these men, ladies and gentlemen, will be burned tonight.
No. One of them's already burned, Michael. I don't understand it. You got to catch a guy on fire? What in the hell are we doing here on SmackDown? Well, Teddy Long has gone completely out of control.
Kane with that big clothesline to MVP, hoping to catch Montel Vontavious Porter on fire here tonight to win this Inferno match. The 300-pounder with a big clothesline to MVP. And Kane building momentum into the side slam.
This is ridiculous. This is sickening. Look at that sick monster. The hell is wrong with Kane?
Off that side slam, those flames shot high into the air again. Nearly engulfing the ring in flames.
It's not enough. MVP beat Kane twice, fair and square.
In a street fight and in a steel cage, albeit by controversial fashion.
Why do they have to resort to something like this? Why would Teddy Long have to do this? MVP is a superstar.
That just seemed to to make Kane mad. MVP trying to get out of the ring.
Get out of there.
Going up to
get
the top rope. MVP on the top rope and off the announce table. But he was managed to, well, he leaped and then was pushed over the flames by the Big Red Machine.
He's not on fire.
Do? No. MVP
come
is
on,
not
come
on fire.
Oh, geez.
This matchup continues. Kane to the top rope. He's measuring MVP. The Big Red Machine taking MVP out and looking over the announce table here. I can tell you,
It's a 300 plus pound man coming off the top rope to the floor. Kane just missed the flames. Look at this.
Look at this, look at this, look at this. Oh my, and Kane goes to the flames as well. Kane is just a hand away. MVP trying to keep himself from going into those flames and burning here.
Spine at 500 degrees.
And there's a big boot off the skull of MVP by Kane.
Kane just smile at the fire?
I think he
Kane
did.
Just smiled at the fire.
You know Kane's history. Look at that sick smile.
Sick. Why would anybody do this to another human being?
Hey, look at MVP trying to find cover underneath the ring.
Do you blame him?
No, not at all. And Kane with a right hand. A big right hand to MVP. The big red machine stalking his prey. MVP to the steel steps, trying to stay in the matchup. But Kane with a hand around his throat.
Come on, no. No.
Oh my God.
Stop it. Somebody
MVP
stop him.
No,
somebody
flames.
Stop him.
Look at this.
Somebody stop him.
MVP.
No. No.
Out of the flames.
No.
MVP.
Oh my God.
Fire.
Somebody stop it. Oh
MVP
my God.
MVP is on fire.
Somebody
MVP
stop
it. MVP is on fire. This matchup's over. But MVP is on
he
fire.
He is on fire. Somebody put him out. For God's sake. Somebody
we need
get
help
back.
Out here. We need help out here. We need help. Oh my God. And finally some aid to MVP who is completely MVP has collapsed.
My somebody
God, get some help out here. MVP collapsing after being burned by
here
Kane.
Here is your winner, Kane.
You call that a winner? You call that freak a winner? I call it a damn travesty. What in the hell? I hope you're proud of yourself, Teddy Long. Look at that. Look at what you've done. You've got a guy who might have third-degree burns on himself right now, and it's all Teddy Long's fault because he put him and he fed him to that damn monster game.